Hello and welcome, fellow gamers. My name is Borek and this is another episode of 7 Days to Die. Actually, I should say Farmer Borek. Yay! We are going to start a farm. Oh, what is that? Is that a bag filled with goodies? No, that's empty shit. Anyway, well, actually, what will happen if we destroy it? Let me just double check that. Will we get some cloth? Yeah, cool. So that's fantastic. Right, so as you can see, I have started making a farm over here because I have found a shitload of fertilizer and I do have some seeds and I want to start growing those thingy-jigs. We're not gonna deal with the corn. Actually, I have 10 fertilizer. So we will be using that, and to use it, you need to hoe your, tilt your ground with a right mouse button, of course. Right mouse button does the hoeing. So in the previous alphas, in the previous version of the game, you get like one tilted row and one untilted and one tilted, you know, blockwise. And anyway, now it just tilt after tilt after tilt. You cannot do anything. Well, actually, I have fertilized the ground over here, the block. Well, okay, fair enough. So I have used one of them, my fertilizer, because one click will just tilt the ground, and then if you use it for the second time, it is fertilized. So these two blocks are fertilized, so we're gonna go with few more, because apparently now the fertilized ground will give you much more crops yield wise of course. So well, I have run out of fertilizer, so I don't know which one. Well, you can see a bit like fertilizer shit over here, but I'm not quite sure which one of those were supposed to be fertilized. But anyway, we'll plant some stuff on it. So I want to grow my mushrooms because I have found two mushrooms, and with a dirt I've made mushroom seeds. So we're gonna place those guys somewhere over here. Is that tilted? Yeah. So they will grow nicely, and the fertilized, anyway, if you place, for example, corn, we will do like testing. If you place corn on untilted ground, it will yield you with one corn. But if you place it on a tilted ground, not fertilized, it will yield you with two corns. And if you place it on the fertilized ground, I hope that's this one or this one, I don't know, let's do the testing. Well, I'm gonna place four of them over here. So you should get like 4 ears of corn, something like that. So I'm gonna place those corns along this side and they should work really nicely. Okay, what else do we have? We have some aloe over here that we will plant on a tilted ground if possible. I don't know if that's tilted. We have some yucca as well. We should place it over here, and one potato nicely. Oh, look at those baby corns and aloes and stuff like that. They look so sweet. We also have some goldenrod, so I'm gonna place two over here. That's a bit difficult because as you can see, the window, the block is over here, and I think it places the crop in this corner. At least it looks like. So we have some chrysanthemum as well, and we will place it. Can I place it somewhere over here? Yeah, that's great. And some blueberries as well, because I have found some. So this one will go here. Ah, fuck. I fucked up one. Anyway, so as you can see, our little farm of trees is growing as well. Is that a bad guy over there? No. So I have started thinking about defenses because, well, it's day 5. As far as I know, Dog Day has been removed from the game, so I shouldn't be worried about that. But I think I'm going to go with the pit again. Have I made that iron shovel? Yes, I did. But now I am debating what should I do. I don't want to hide underground, so this is just a temporarily safe haven for me. But I think I would like to build a big structure on top of it. But if I do, I need some supports. Support-wise, well, 5 across might be a bit too much, even for the concrete. So I think I will just go with 3x3 section for the zombies, and the walls will go over here like that. So this is gonna be the wall made out of pillars. Made out of pillars, and then I will have a walking area over here that is gonna be, it might be 3 wide. So yeah, basically what will happen is that I'm gonna dig this one like so. So what will happen is that the zombies will fall into the pit. I will have spikes fully upgraded over there without central pillar, and as far as I know, with during the seven day horde, you will get maximum of 8 zombies at a time. They will be spawning whole night long, but that's gonna be just 8 of them. 8 of them at a time. So if I have 9 spikes, that should be enough. So this is gonna be the wall, protective wall made out of 50 pillars made out of cobblestone. Right, of course on top there's gonna be blocks, full blocks with cobblestone. So yeah, that's gonna be really, really awesome. Although this will require a shitload of digging, but having in mind that I really don't have that much time, I don't have enough materials, I don't have resources, I don't have stone. Well, stone is not an issue, but I don't have metal, I don't have wood nearby. I've started making those woodlock spikes. I would like to go as deep as possible with this design, so we don't actually need to hit, I don't know how deep the stone is gonna be, because that's gonna be really pain in the ass. But at least I would like to, you know, this is gonna be the level, the ground level, and on top of it there's gonna be some spikes as well, and the zombies will drop down there. So I think I need at least 1, 2, 3 levels deep, 3 levels deep, so I can securely place 3 high. Do I have that cobblestone? Let's make that. That's double cobblestone pillar. So I'm gonna make 3 or 4. Let me just think about that. So this is gonna be add cobblestone frame. Yeah, so let's start crafting that as well. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can have a basic idea what do I want to do. So this one will go over here, and then underneath, so this needs to be, oh shit, where is that shovel? So this one should go right underneath the second one, and the third one, of course. So right over here there's gonna be those guys, and probably if that's the fourth level, I think that might be floor, or I might even go one deeper. Yeah, I think I will just go one deeper. Yeah. So this one will be the floor. Actually, it doesn't need to be made out of those things, but yeah, for stability, let's do it, and for the sake of the gameplay. Right, so I need to dig this whole section out, which is gonna take me quite some time, but I would like to check a few things as well. Let's just get out of here. Right, so that's gonna look something like that, and we're gonna have all, we will have them all around, and over here there's gonna be 9 spikes that will not take so many materials. And here on top, as soon as I fill those guys, the cobblestones, probably I will just make it defensive wise all the way over here with the cobblestone, and I will cover that with spikes as well. You know, the ordinary spikes. That is going to be so cool. I hope this can withstand. And anyway, construction tools, I've been doing some upgrading. So as you can see, now I'm level 18. And at level 20, we will get the concrete mixing. So I'm saving my points for that. I don't know if I have an engine or not, but I also found a really strange thing in the random gen. I don't know if you have seen that in your gameplays, but why the hell this section is blocked? Actually, can I place... See, I even cannot place a goddamn thing over here. This is not a trader. I don't know if there's some error on the map, but I have seen some of those guys, some of those sections somewhere over there in the snowy biome when my game crashed. But anyway, if you have any idea what the hell is going on, please do let me know in the comment section down below. I would really appreciate that. That would be so cool. Right, so as you can see, the time is passing by, and I wanted to check. Yeah, I have my Stevens treasure map on me, so let's read that and let's check how far that treasure map, that treasure actually is away from us. Well, there is a drop. There is an airdrop somewhere over here. We're not going to go there because they have been nerfed. But the treasure is somewhere over there. I'm not feeling like going just right now because I am really running short on time and I need to get some materials. Like basically shitloads of wood, and I need to get some more of these guys. Well, we can actually start upgrading and clay as well. So yeah, you really need to go materials gathering style, but for the sake of now, we can, you know, just start upgrading those thingy jigs. Okay, so they upgrade completely into concrete, I believe, and they have 1500 durability points or health points. This one as well. I don't know if they will hold. If not, well, probably I will just make a runaway gateway, like a tunnel leading to that base, so I can, if this section will be compromised, I can go back to my base and GTFO basically from over there, or hide. I don't know. I don't want to do the kill zone thingy jig that everybody does. I just want to check if that zombie pit is still a thing and if I can successfully survive at least 7th day horde. So on top of it, I would in the future like to build like a big ass structure that will help us. That will help us survive, because as I said, I don't want to be hiding under the ground. So yeah, that's gonna be it. Right, so it's high noon. I think I just need to go and get some stuff. I'm just gonna dig outline over here, and because I will be digging at night, there is really no point for me of doing that right now to lose the daylight, because I don't want to be stuck over here with shitloads of zombies running around. Right, so let's finish this off. And actually, let's make those cobblestone frames. Let's make like 20, because why not? We have some materials, and then let's start making those cobblestone rocks as well, because I believe we will be needing a lot. And actually, quarter blocks, wood, concrete. Well, that's not quarter, that's quarter. So we don't have, I don't have concrete, so I cannot make those slabs. But I think I can make a repair system with the pillars as well. So I think we're gonna go with that underneath the spikes. And if I have a time, I will dig second level, so we can loot and so we can loot and get those guys from down below or even place those spikes. I'm playing on the 60 minute daytime, so that shouldn't be that big of a deal. I mean, time wise, for the zombies on the day 7. 1, 2. No, that's not it. Over here. Like so. So basically, they should fall into here, and let's hope that they will stay down there. I think I have a minigun waiting for the action, so let's actually check how does this do, how, if it's good or not. I have absolutely no idea where it is. Oh, that 60 minute daytime is really pain in the ass, and I don't have any. Ah, there it is, nail gun. Sweet. That is really fantastic. Why does this does not burn? I don't know. Let's add something to the fire, because we need to make a shitload of forged iron as well. And yeah, huh, that is gonna be a tough one. So if I have a time, I will make a shooting gallery. I want to make a shooting gallery. Well, let me just upgrade those corners. Oh, this goes so quickly. I don't know. Whoops. I didn't want to do that. But look at that. Look at that. This is really fantastic. Look at me go. All I need is just materials. That's basically what I need at this point. But and upgrading. Well, that is not an issue with the minigun. And it doesn't lose it doesn't lose durability so fast. So yeah, that is cool. Right, digging. And then, if I have a time, I would really like to do something like that. So I will place those pillars, maybe the big pillars. Cobblestone, so that they might look cool. Maybe like that. Maybe those, instead of those thingy-jigs. Like 3 high. And on top of it, I can make iron bars and shoot the zombies that are in the pit from up above. That is an idea of mine. But right now, all I need to do is just go and gather materials, go and gather clay, and I will be heading over here because I know that there is a really nice forest area. So I'm just gonna drop off some stuff and head there to get shitloads of wood, because probably I will need it. I don't know, I just want to get some of it. Let me just take this. That I don't need. I really don't need that. I could use some of those guys. And I need to find feathers, because, well, feather-wise, I suck bad as well. Right, so off we go. Let's go to that distant land and maybe we'll find something cool. I don't know. I don't remember if there is any town nearby as well. But we need those feathers, since I don't have any weapon whatsoever. I don't have any pump shotgun. I don't have any. I don't have crossbow. Maybe I will be lucky and find one. Well, we will see. So I guess that's gonna be a bit shorter episode. But as I said, I need to get that wood. I need to get those stones. I need to get that clay and start making those cobblestones. So I think that's going to be it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it, at least a bit. And so if you did, hit that like button in the section down below, comment about the gameplay, and I hope we'll see each other in the next episode. So till then, take it easy, have fun, and happy gaming. Bye-bye.